morning and welcome to the Morning Expresso by the Indian Express. My name is Rahil Philippos and here is today's big story. The government has approved extending a guarantee of ₹30,600 crore to the National Assets Reconstruction Company Limited to help clear the banking sector's stressed assets of around 2 lakh crore in a time-bound manner. A total of ₹90,000 crore of stressed assets against which banks have made 100% provisions in their books of accounts will be transferred to the NARCL in the first phase. On Prime Minister Narendra Modi's 71st birthday, Union Minister Prakash Javdekar writes on what Modi completing 20 uninterrupted years in office, first as Chief Minister of Gujarat and then as PM, means for India. Now, here are our top stories from the front page. Calling it a democratic experiment, the BJP has ushered in an all-new ministry in Gujarat, replacing all existing names just about a year ahead of assembly elections in the state. Only three in the government of Chief Minister Bhupendra Patel, who himself is a first-time MLA, have held ministerial posts in the past. In the shake-up, which involved a balance of both caste and regional representation, those dropped include powerful Deputy Chief Minister Nitin Patel. Much like his mentor MS Dhoni, Virat Kohli announced that he was stepping down as captain of the Indian team at the T20 World Cup, which is set to commence in the UAE on October 17. Kohli's statement mentioned Rohit Sharma as an essential part of the leadership group, all but anointing the latter as his successor in the shortest format. Days ahead of the Quad Summit, US President Joe Biden, UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson, and Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison have unveiled an ambitious security initiative which is expected to help Australia acquire nuclear-powered submarines in a bid to counter China's growing power in the strategically vital Indo-Pacific region. Now, here are today's must-read stories. After travelling 70 kilometres from her hometown to Tezpur to appear for an entrance examination for Jorhat's Assam Agricultural University, 19-year-old Jubli Tamuli was stopped from entering the exam hall as she was wearing a pair of shorts. Tamuli was eventually permitted to take the examination, but only after she agreed to wrap her legs with a curtain. In the past 2 years, under the shadow of the COVID pandemic, enrollment in Rajasthan's government schools across classes 1 to 12 has increased by almost 10 lakh. Officials in the state's Directorate of Secondary Education say that the numbers will probably increase by another 1.5 to 2 lakhs in the next 15 to 20 days as the numbers are added up. The jump is in line with the nationwide trend of private school children, particularly in rural and poor urban areas, shifting to government institutes. After 26-year-old Bindu R.D., a resident of H. Rampura village in the Devanagari district, wrote a strongly worded letter addressed to Karnataka Chief Minister Basav Raj Bommai, bemoaning the poor state of roads in her village, district officials immediately promised action. In her letter, Bindu said that she would not get married until her demands were met, as then there would be no one left to fight for her village. Kerala's Kannur University has announced that it will not be teaching the works of V.D. Savarkar and M.S. Golwarkar, which were included in the syllabus of the postgraduate course in Governance and Politics. The decision comes after recommendations made by a two-member committee set up by the university to review the syllabus. This also comes after opposition parties and left academicians accused the ruling CPIM of facilitating the saffronization of education in the state. And finally, from the javelin thrown by Olympic gold medalist Neeraj Chopra to the boxing gloves worn by Lovlina Borgohain, at least 1,300 gifts and mementos received by Prime Minister Narendra Modi over the years will be up for grabs in an upcoming e-auction organized by the Ministry of Culture to mark his 71st birthday. The proceeds from the auction will go towards the Namami Gange project aimed at conserving and rejuvenating the Ganga River.